So you're ready to record audio into FL Studio. The assumption is you have an audio interface, you have your instrument plugged in to the audio interface is connected to FL Studio, and now you can start the recording process. In this lesson, we're going to take a look at how to set that all up.
Now, let's say I would like to record some audio into this project. We need to do some setup first. Well, the first thing I'm going to do here is to save this project. I'll go to File here and select Save. I'll give this a name. Recording test, hit save, and now this project is saved onto my desktop. Now, unfortunately, FL Studio does not save all the audio recordings into the same location as the project, but we can change that. I'm going to click on Options over here and select Project General Settings, and over here we have a data folder. The data folder is where all the audio recordings go to. So I can click on this folder icon here and set it to a specific location. As you can see here, it's going into some projects folder inside the FL Studio folder. I'm just going to choose desktop and choose that same location where my project file is. And I'm going to create a new folder. I'll call this recording test and set that as the project data folder. Now, FL Studio is asking us if you would like to save the project into that folder. And that makes sense. So I'll choose yes. So now all the recordings are going into this folder. And the project is also inside this folder, so everything is organized. All right, the next thing we need to set up is under the audio tab, we want to choose the audio interface we're using. So I'm using this Universal Audio Thunderbolt audio interface. And then the next thing we need to set is the buffer length. Just like when we're working with MIDI devices, when we're recording audio, the buffer length also comes into play. So if you want low latency monitoring, you want to set the buffer length to a low value. But also keep in mind, the lower this value is, the more CPU usage will increase. So you have to find that sweet spot where your buffer length is giving you low latency, while at the same time, your CPU is not getting overloaded. All right, I think I'm good with this because this project is technically completely empty. So I'll close out this window, and now I'm ready to record. So we can record into the playlist or record into the Edison audio editor. Let's take a look at the setup involved to record into the playlist. So in this project, I already have these four sounds loaded into the channel rack. I would like to record into the playlist, so I can right-click this track one here, and under track mode, I will choose audio track. Now, I'm not going to use those first four inserts because they are probably being used for the four sounds in the channel rack, so I'll use anything else. I'm just going to start from 10. So now insert 10 on the mixer has been connected to this first track on the playlist. If I open up the mixer, you can see here insert 10 has a little icon that says A because it's set to audio track mode. I can also right click here, rename this track. And now you can see how the name is reflected in the playlist. So these two tracks are linked. Let's talk about some of these options over here. So the first thing is the audio input source. So this is where you will set the specific input on your audio interface. As you can see, I have a variety of different inputs. These are the stereo ones and these are the mono ones. Let me choose the microphone that I'm using right now, and that's this input here. Now, as soon as we set that input, we get this pop-up that's saying, you've selected an external input. Do you want to switch to external input only to avoid recording internal audio on this track? So yes, you can record internally onto a track, let's say the audio from one track into another audio track, but I do not want to do that. So let's switch it to external input only. So now this track is dedicated for recording audio from the external world only. Now already we're hearing the sound of my voice through this track. I'm going to just disarm the track and now we're not hearing my voice anymore. You can arm or disarm by clicking over here. And you can also do that from the mixer. You can see there's this little red button here. So now my voice is going through that mixer insert. All right, let's take a look at some of the other options here. So we set our input, and over here we have monitoring options. So at the bottom here, there are three options, monitor off, when armed, or on. And this is fairly self-explanatory. So currently it's set to when armed. So as soon as I arm the track, you will hear the incoming signal. And that's what was happening earlier. But I can also set it to off. So even if the track is armed, you can see here the signal is going through, but we're not hearing anything through FL Studio. And then lastly, we have on. where the signal is always being monitored, if the track is armed or disarmed. It makes sense to set it to when armed, so you only hear the input when you are planning to record. All right, so those are all the settings you need to know for recording audio into FL Studio.